John Lennon was one of the most beloved songwriters of his time, and was taken from the world far too soon in a tragic murder. John Lennon left a musical mark on the industry that to this day continues to mystify so many people, and he would be in his 80s if he were still alive today. In today's video, we'll go over some of the top unknown facts about John Lennon you probably didn't know about. Ready to join the finest squad? Then make sure to subscribe with notifications on so you don't miss any of our interesting videos ever again. That being said, let's begin. Beatles Secrets. John once said in an interview that the best stuff the Beatles ever recorded was never released to the public. However, some people are saying that his statements were misunderstood. This was said during a Rolling Stone magazine interview in 1971, and he made some bold statements that the Beatles had actually recorded some really stellar rock and roll, but they never planned on releasing it. However, he had another meaning to this statement as well. He also meant that the group was being held back due to some creative differences. John claims that when they were recording, some of them would feel physically and mentally drained. They had exhausting demands, and they never expected in their wildest dreams to become nearly as popular as they were. As the fans were always demanding more, they were starting to run out of ideas, and John also feels that some of their best work never came out of them because they were never running at 100%. He claims that the band kinda killed themselves just to make it, and that fame had come with an unfortunate price. He played many instruments. John Lennon was a man of many talents, and singing was just one of his best. When John Lennon was very young, he met a really nice bus driver that decided to give him one of the earliest instruments he ever had as a child. He received a harmonica as a gift, and he found out that he had a natural knack for the instrument. As a matter of fact, during the early days of the Beatles, he actually played the harmonica extensively, and it wasn't until later on during his success that he stopped playing it. So many people don't know that he knew how to play the harmonica. When he was young, his mother also bought him a banjo and taught him how to play it. She also would be the one to buy him his very first guitar, something he practiced on extensively. He wasn't done there though, because playing the harmonica, the banjo, and the guitar simply wasn't enough for John Lennon. He also learned how to play a mellotron keyboard, which isn't something he practiced a lot, and you rarely ever saw him playing it. But according to sources, he was actually pretty good at the keyboard. He didn't feel adequate enough, though, to play in shows. Let It Be was the end. There are a lot of rumors and reasons as to why the Beatles ended. The price of their quickly rising fame was starting to get to them, and they were tired of being sidelined towards the end. It can take a toll on anyone, and it was in a documentary that John Lennon expressed his true feelings on Paul McCartney. He stated that a lot of other members were tired of being the sideline for Paul, and that they felt he was hogging a lot of the spotlight for something that they were all putting a lot of their own work, sweat, and blood into. Regardless of who put in more work, all of them were extremely talented. However, they didn't see it that way. They claimed that the documentary Let It Be in 1970 was actually a film set up completely for Paul McCartney. For them, Let It Be was the absolute last straw and would spell the ultimate demise of the band. They couldn't come to an agreement anymore after the documentary released and said that they were fed up with everything. Apparently, Paul was enjoying his fame way too much to stand aside or agree to cut back a little, and that was the last straw. Do you think Paul was just being selfish? Do you think the band made the right choice? John Lennon wanted more. If you were a Beatle, everyone knew your name and everyone saw you as one of the most famous people in the world at the time. Who could blame them? Sure, he was incredibly famous, but the title of being one of the Beatles was starting to get to him, and he wanted to reach out for more. A lot of band members started feeling the same way right before they split up, and Lennon in particular had been feeling this way for a while. This was something that he had been thinking about for some time before the band decided to finally call it quits. John Lennon was one of the most talented members of the group, and he brought so much to the table that he felt others were starting to slack in what they brought to the table. He was a very diverse artist and a restless person, always trying to create something new and always buzzing with new ideas. He was a highly creative personality, and no one could stand in the way of his creativity. He also started to pursue other venues such as acting. He wanted to take on writing, and he wanted to get involved in painting. If he were never murdered, he more than likely would have made it. his thoughts on Elvis Presley. John Lennon wasn't exactly the biggest fan of Elvis Presley, and we think that's more than apparent during one of his interviews. In a 1980 interview he conducted with Playboy, yes, he actually did an interview with Playboy, he shared some of his thoughts on Elvis Presley and where he thought he ended up. However, some of the people who listened to this interview misinterpreted him, because while he wasn't fond of Elvis, he wasn't exactly insulting Elvis with his comments either. He had a very grim view of the industry at this point and what it did to people just trying to become successful. He claimed that rock and roll had taken a major piece of his soul away and he was being physically tortured from the lifestyle that he had to live. He said that living rock and roll wasn't fun anymore, and he didn't want to keep going down the path he was going down, especially after seeing the path that so many rock stars go down once their fame is up. He said most people end up in Las Vegas singing their greatest hits, and if they're lucky, they end up going to hell, which is where Elvis Presley went. What do you think he meant by his comments? He gave Bruce Springsteen advice. It's hard to imagine that Bruce Springsteen would ever need advice from anyone, even the great John Lennon, but that's exactly what Lennon offered. He wanted to give some advice to the up-and-coming superstar. He was doing an interview with the Rolling Stones in the 1980s, and he had some harsh words for the up-and-coming rock star, but offered some sincere advice. We want to make clear that it doesn't appear that he really had any kind of ill will towards Bruce Springsteen at all. It's very clear at this point that Lennon was very bitter from the life he had lived, and he wasn't happy with what the price of fame was. He was kind of beat down, and he had this look on the world that made it a pessimistic place. He thought that everyone who was destined for fame was going to end up like most rock stars, and they were going to end up just like him. Miserable. He told Rolling Stone that he hopes Bruce survives when they all turn on him and decide he's no longer God. What he meant by that could be many things. The gorilla suit. When John Lennon was still in the Beatles, he thought for some reason that the band should buy a suit. So, we're not sure where he found one of these, but he decided to buy a full gorilla suit. Back during this time, it was one of the most interesting celebrity purchases of all time, because no celebrity, at least in immediate history that we know of, had gone out of their way to purchase a gorilla suit. Some people said that it was just for him to ditch the paparazzi and stay out of the spotlight. Others say he wanted to wear the thing because he thought it was cool. He did, however, say that he had vivid dreams of wearing the gorilla suit while he was driving the Ferrari down the highway, which, we have to admit, is a really cool image to have in your head, but it never happened. He was critical of himself. Of all the things John Lennon was critical of, he was most critical of himself. We know a lot of people probably either don't believe that or have a rather hard time believing that, but he didn't listen to himself sing. He couldn't listen to himself sing, and it was rather difficult for him to listen to his own songs, even through his own band. Some people even said that during interviews, he would turn songs off if they featured his own voice in them, and he highly disliked hearing his own voice. Even the producer of the Beatles song said he couldn't quite understand it because everyone else loved it. Lennon always wanted his producer to put some effects on his voice to make him sound different, but it's probably a good thing that he didn't, right? Dear Prudence. When Mia Farrow's sister Prudence wasn't feeling very well, she attended a meeting that the Beatles would be visiting. Prudence was attending a healing session with the guru Maharishi Mahesh Yogi. While meeting the Beatles, Prudence took a really kind liking to John Lennon, and John Lennon, in return, actually wrote a song for Prudence called Dear Prudence. The song itself was rather touching, and it was a very beautifully written song. However, something amazing started to happen. While Prudence had been very sick, the song that Lennon was singing had actually cheered her up, and then the meme was born that Dear Prudence actually had healing powers. Of course, memes back then weren't on the internet since it wasn't a thing, but Prudence swore every day that the song actually healed her through some healing power that she couldn't understand. John Lennon and David Bowie hated fame. If it's not quite evident yet, John Lennon obviously had a disdain for the fame that he had achieved and wanted to always warn other people of the price you had to pay when fame comes your way. During his interviews, he always wanted to warn other rock stars of what fame does to people and what it costs people. Lennon believed that a piece of his soul was torn out when he achieved fame, and he thought he could never get it back. He thought some rock stars were actually making deals with the devil in order to achieve their fame. David Bowie and John Lennon actually co-wrote the song Fame together, which helped share their disdain for fame with the world. While a lot of people couldn't understand his hate for fame, he'd seen the worst of it and thought he was headed towards a path of destruction, like a lot of rock stars, such as Elvis. And during the 80s, the height of drug usage was at an all-time high for rock bands. Do you think of John Lennon differently after knowing all of this about him? Maybe do a little more digging of your own. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.